I would like to begin this video by thanking all my viewers and subscribers for your lovely comments that keeps me encouraged and motivated to bring in new products and review every week. Now, it's very common to see watercolor paints in pans, tubes, bottles, and even in crayons and pencils. But the product that I would be reviewing today has watercolor paints in a very unique format, as chips. This is the Mangyo watercolor chip of 12 shades. Now, Mangyo Kojai is a Korean brand and they are known globally for their superior brands of soft pastels, oil pastels, and watercolors. In this product, they have used their skills and knowledge as market leaders to create a new format of watercolors that makes it compact, travel friendly, and easy to use. The set comes in this beautifully packaged petite size box. On the bottom here, you get a glimpse of all the colors that are provided inside, and the same is also given on the side of the box. Almost all the text on the outside is written in Korean, but when translated to English, this is what it says on the back of the box. The color is discharged when contacted with water. Light and convenient card type watercolors make your artistic sense to be expressed anytime, anywhere. It is made of 12 colors and you can see vivid and transparent colors. And then on the side of the box, the text is again in Korean, but translated to English, it says, "Caution, don't apply on face or skin. Do not place under direct sun, it may cause discoloration. Avoid high humidity, pigments may melt or deteriorate. Keep in dry place. Touching with sweaty or watery hands may pollute hands. Wash hands after use." Let's open the packaging and check the watercolor chips now. All the color chips are held together with a narrow removable plastic wrap. There are holes punched on the top left corner of each individual color chip. There's also a plastic palette provided, which too has a hole punched through it. Let me explain the purpose of these holes. Enclosed in the box is also a metallic ring. The purpose of the ring is to hold all the chips and the palette together. The ring is easy to open and close, which means that you can easily release the chip cards and palette when you're using it and then pop it right back after use. Let's take a closer look at the color chips now. Each card is 7 cm wide and 10.5 cm long. The thickness and flexibility are similar to a thick cardstock paper. The paint pigments is laid on one side of the card and on the back you have all the details pertaining to that specific shade. So here you have the shade number and the shade name. The star here indicates light fastness, which is basically a color's ability to withstand exposure to light and humidity without fading over time. The three stars indicate that this shade has high light fastness and thus it has the ability to retain its vibrancy over 100 years or so. The alphabet shows the series number, which basically is an indication of pigment quality, so I reckon A means superior quality pigments were used to make this shade. The square box shows the transparency. A blank box like this means that this shade is highly transparent. And then you get information about the specific pigments used to make this color. So here only one pigment, PY14, was used to make the shade of yellow. I truly prefer colors which are made with only one or two pigments, since I can then mix them with other shades with minimal chances of creating muddy colors. The palette is made of hard yet flexible plastic with ample space for mixing colors. Now let's do a swatch test to test out the shades. The paint pigments get activated the moment water touches its surface, and one can pick ample amount of colors on the brush without any vigorous rubbing. There is also generous amount of pigment on each card, as even the tiniest area releases significant amount of color. The colors are bright, vibrant, and vivid. The selection of shades is really good. Now let's do a quick sketch to check the value range. The colors are easy to pick from the chip and the palette provides sufficient space to mix the various hues. The transparency of the colors is really good and the colors are blending beautifully together. The value range is fantastic and I'm able to get the lightest light and the darkest dark easily, which is so important for watercolor sketches. The Mungyo watercolor chips were a sheer delight to use. Now personally, I feel more confident using shades in which the pigment details have been disclosed. In case of the Mungyo colors, most shades were made with single pigment, thus drastically reducing the chance of mixing muddy colors, making this set not only great for professional artists, but also for beginners. The colors are bright and vibrant, the transparency is good, and it's possible to mix a wide hue of shades with the colors that are provided in the box. Another advantage is the fact that because the chip and the accompanying palette is petite size, it makes it convenient to carry during travel or during plein air painting. However, at Rs. 430, this product is pricey, especially when you consider how tiny the chips are. The size limitation also makes it difficult to use large size brushes or use these paints to cover larger surface area. Another disadvantage is the fact that if you have unusually sweaty palms, then you will end up with unexpected paint stains on your fingers. But despite these limitations, I really think you should try out the Mungyo watercolor chips for their great pigment quality and their ingenious, compact and travel-friendly format. If you enjoyed this video, do click the like button and do subscribe to my channel to watch an art supply review every Wednesday.